This holding Villawood's boundary fence became a gateway to freedom for 23 asylum seekers, but not before a terrible price was paid in blood. The detainees had to saw and cut their way through two fences before confronting the razor wire. Here the barbs are bent and distorted by the escapees pushing through, clothing which became snagged, simply discarded in their desperate dash for freedom.
The holes that the detainees are escaping through are symbolic, I guess, of the holes in the detention centre policy.
And the minister, having to confront the second mass escape from Villawood in a matter of days, now threatening prison-like security upgrades.
Some of the amenity of the facility has to be compromised to maintain security. That's what we're going to have to look at.
But with 46 Villawood detainees now on the loose in Sydney, many are suggesting it's a case of closing the gate with the horse long gone.
The reality is he's become the Colonel Clink, if you like, of Australia's detention regime.
Put down defences!
This latest breakout sparking a noisy demonstration at Villawood today, calling for all detention centres to be shut down. That same message delivered more quietly by others.
There are plenty of countries in the world which release refugees and asylum seekers into the community.
Despite the threat of jail for harbouring any of these latest asylum seekers, this group behind me have announced loud and clear they'll assist them whenever they can.
We stand with these people. We stand with them as human beings. If that's a crime, lock us all up.
None of the 46 Villawood runaways have so far been caught. Tim Collins, 10 News.